All right, so now we're back over here at the charging table. And this charging table here was one that I created because I started working with charging about a year ago. And you saw my video earlier, my photos earlier of my primitive charging table. I needed something a little beefier. So this actually will do 28 cells in a charge mode, and then it does 12 in discharge. And every section is switched so that if I have a cell that comes from a laptop battery and it gets hot, or I can feel it start getting warm, I can kill that battery just by switching it off without affecting the rest of them. So it keeps them kind of independent, and they go on blocks of four. So when we were over there, we were processing some cells. And so what I'll do is I'll go ahead and start sticking these in. These are the ones that we're checking, you know, they were new cells. I finished that whole block. We had that whole block of cells that we started doing some logging on. All right, so we had gone through and processed these four cells here because they've sat for their time period, and I need to bring those up to a charge. So I'm gonna jump over here into this charging station, and I'm gonna run these cells up. What this table does here is it goes right straight to 4.2 volts and allows me to just get it right to the top, so I am consistent on my the amount of discharge that I have, or the amount of capacity that's on or in each cell. So the thing that's really important about that, it's like water. So if you fill a tank with water and then you want to determine how much is in that tank, and it's only, you know, 9/10 full, when you go to drain it, yeah, your capacity is going to be lower. But if you take that tank all the way to the top and then drain it to figure out what the volume is in it, then you get a good capacity reading. And likewise, if you take these cells and you drive them over 4.2, which is not recommended, then yeah, you're going to get a higher capacity, but you're also stressing the cell, and you don't want to do that. So 4.2 is the limit. Run up to 4.2, and then you can come back down and be able to determine what the actual volume is that is in each cell. So as this is waiting to process, this will take a few minutes for this to get up. We have these other two cells that we ran through. This one here had completed that process. We had the ohms, or the resistance, on it here, and this was the capacity. And so basically I just need to stick it in for a charge, so I'll just add it to the charge table as well, and it'll go through. And this one here is ready for its wait period, and I think, yeah, that one's fully charged. See, the light stayed green. So let me pull that back out so that we can take a look at, I'll show you what I do in my stacks over here. So these cell holders are really, really tight. Okay, so if I pull this around over here, what I have here is multiple stacks. These are all cells that are waiting. They've all gone through the charging process and they've all been cataloged. And so they are waiting for discharge and they're getting close. So this is my 900 series, which is what we're discharging right now is the 900 series. And then right below it are the 1000. So this here is cell 1000, and it'll start into my 1000 series. And then so on and so forth. In the back I have this in here is 1100, and right below it is 1200. So we have like at least 340 more cells that need processed here. This stack here in the front is for cells that have been charged and are ready for to go into the waiting process. And so, and they all go in numeric order. So that's 1341 was that one. This one here is 1342, and so on and so forth. And then as these are finished charging, I'll get their finished charge voltage, and then they'll go in here for their wait period of 14 days. So let's go back over and check that voltage to see if we're close to 4.2 volts so it can discharge. And all these cells over here are completed cells. So these are ones that you've seen. Okay, these are close. And we're almost ready to. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna let this run out, and then I'll turn the video back on and we'll start the discharge process, you can see how I initiate that. All right, guys, so I finished charging these up. So now what I'm gonna do is just start them on a discharge cycle so you can see the discharge itself. All I do is just go ahead and turn on my discharge units. These discharge units have resistors on the back side that will actually draw the juice out of these. So as it goes through those resistors, it chews up all the stuff that's in them, and these actually just mark or keep track of how much was actually in the cell as it was being processed. So as I stick these in, you can see it'll pop up. These are not completely accurate. I trust my volt ohm meter better, but it was at 4.2 on my volt ohm meter. So let me pop these in. And then once they're in, all I do is just hit the go button and just start. So we'll just get these all started. And so now they're all being processed. It'll take roughly a couple hours for them to go through and do their thing. Some of these are getting pretty close. This one's at 17. That shows that's at 18. So these are getting closer on this bottom rail, and the ones that are charging down here are still charging. There are different ways to do charging. You don't have to use these chipsets. You know, you can buy chargers like DIY Powerwall. He went and just bought a bunch of pre-mades, and they run off USB ports, and those work great. They'll actually charge and discharge. When I was initially doing my stuff, I was using my IMAX B6 Mini for doing my discharge, and that was about it. The only thing I use it for now is just actually checking my resistance on the cells. All right, guys, I hope that was helpful. Like I said, you don't have to do things my way. I just wanted to share with you the amount of stuff that I actually gather for each cell and how I go through the process of making sure that the cells are in good working order. This really works well, especially with laptop batteries that are pretty much junk. Well, they're rated as junk, but we're resalvaging them. We're making them better. We're reutilizing the stuff that is, you know, would have been thrown away. So this is good. We're saving some landfill and making a difference. So if you really like this video, if you like the stuff that I'm doing, please subscribe below. Tell your friends about it. Give me a thumbs up so, you know, I can start to be able to see more interaction. And leave comments. Please leave comments in the comment section below. I do like to hear from people, and I do respond. So if you've ever read any of my comments on any of my videos, I do reach back out to individuals who reach out and have questions or would like more information. So with that, I will call it a night. Thank you for your time. Appreciate you watching. Until next time.